in the first time, the 12 Forerunner World Gates were found. With it came the gift of travel, and the trade routes between the surface and the underworld were established. But the peace did not last. Soon the gazes turned on the Forerunner relics, fueling the gates. A terrible war ensued. Countless cities were razed to the ground, and the civilizations with them. Without the power of the relics, the world gates fell silent, one by one. With uniting the relics, one could reawaken the gates of Thanatos and reopen the way to the surface. We already possess one of these relics, the Orb of Wisdom. With the information obtained from the Sunken City, we have located the resting place of the final orb. It lies in the Temple of the Drowned God, our final destination.
Hello everyone and welcome back to the Hive and welcome to the pre-ultimate mission. And we don't really seem to have a whole lot of resources on this map here. We've got a lot of space here, but and we do have minerals here, which is good, but we need food. So we've got some food here. So may as well make my home here. Yeah, this looks like a halfway decent spot. I've got four resources here. Well, four different spots where I can get some food. And I have enough to build a hive and a barracks, which are the most important buildings, obviously. So let's get our hive going. And is that even called the hive? I always call it the hive, because it's my HQ and it's the name of the game. But anyway, this looks like one of those bridges that can be raised via an event. So let's, whoop. Cutscene.
Our strike at the heart of the Chalatoi Empire has left a mark. The whole empire is crumbling around them. The other races have sensed this weakness and strike at them to regain territory. Strike down the Aralok Lizardmen and search the area for anything valuable that has been left behind.
Oh, I will. I'll take all those sweet, sweet items from there. Still warm corpses. So, well, they're the lizard people, so they aren't really all that warm in the first place. So you harvest here. And two more of you.
We require more food.
Again, I'm pretty sure I only clicked that once, but whatever. Doesn't really matter. So, this map here. So it features both lizardmen and, woo, a lot of corpses. And some of the Chalatoi, but not a whole lot. These ones, you have a nice 10-pin formation. Or 9-pin, whatever. So you can harvest this guy here. You can harvest that guy. And, or Gal, maybe it's a female turtle, who knows. And another worker. Here we go. And it's really noticeable that these guys here got two defense upgrades and an attack upgrade, because when I first started playing this game I didn't have all these upgrades. These guys here would be almost half dead after fighting a turtle, and now they barely take any damage, so that was quite noticeable. So I've got... wasn't there... yeah, there's another turtle here. I might as well harvest that now. So, but first, let me build a barracks for obvious reasons. So, and I think, are those my only sources of food? They are. I mean, it's not terrible. 300 is pretty solid. How much does the turtle give me? 250. It's not terrible, but going to have to move out, because there's a decent number of guys here. And they aren't weak, exactly, so... So there's some more resources here. And there's some more here. So I really have to... So these missions, they don't really seem to be all that fast-paced. They seem to be more focused on seeing what kind of resources you have and managing... Like, you know, throughout the entire mission. Why? What's up with that term? Anyway, let's get legionnaires. At least these food sources here are close. That's always appreciated. Here you can kill that one. Let's scan the map a little bit. Obviously we should kill these guys here first. Maybe it's like in the last mission where all of them drop artifacts. That would be awesome. So how do I get... Yeah, I'm pretty sure... The gates to these guys here will be opened as soon as I destroy these guys here, because this just smells like a bridge that's going to be open at one point in the mission. So let's get the Hive Queen. The avatar only costs 100 food. That's actually a pretty good deal. I'm pretty sure the avatar is better than, let's say, two legionnaires. I want to get all the units sooner or later anyway, but yeah. And maybe I should get a medic, because, well, I can't afford one right now anyway, and I need to farm crystals before. I've got some here, 250, it's not too shabby. I need to farm some crystals before I can even get those, but generally spoken, let's get the avatar next. Generally spoken, they could actually help me. I don't really like about them that they can't revive units and only heal them, but even healing them could be useful, so I can't. Maybe stay in the field a little bit longer. So let's get the avatar. That's a weird symbol. I'm pretty sure that's a face, like the abominable lobster face, but it kind of looks like a guy who's crossing his arms in front of his face. Which is odd, but then again, it's not like these creatures here have regular biology in the first place. But hey, who cares? So I think with these guys here, I can move out and kill some of these guys here. Because I seem to be largely safe for now. So, you guys... Oh! This guy here, ooh. Oh, I think he's just on patrol. But I may as well kill them. Kill him and his friends. Now that's... Oh, these guys are ranged. I remember that. It's always a little bit annoying. So let's get... all of these guys. Let's get some... I think this one here was... Life Leech. I like the Life Leech ability, it's very good. That's very good at keeping the queen alive. Give this one here. I want to spread out my items a little bit. You get this other one here. Yep, that sounds like a good combo to me. You guys can get some stuff. Maybe the shield here, maybe that, and so can you guys. I'll give these to my melee units. My range units don't really need those. Well, they could still use them. It's not like they aren't useful, but they're more useful for the frontliners for obvious reasons. You don't have any stuff. What does this do again? Health. I think I'll keep those for the bees. But you can get this. So that's not too shabby an army. But let's get... Oh, that's not actually my barracks. I may as well get these guys and more legionnaires and then move out against these guys here. Who are a lot closer than I thought. They're only about one screen away. Looked like they were further away on the screen, but who cares. So here we go. Yeah, when you fight weak units like the Chalatoi workers, you can even get into a situation where your queen regenerates health faster than she's losing it, which is convenient when you want to heal her by just leeching on workers. So you are dead, and so are you. These guys, they do some decent damage. They're not that weak. Especially not now that I haven't really leveled up my units. This might actually be a good game for transferring units to make it even more roleplay than it already is. So you get over here, you can join those guys, and you can join these guys here. They already have pretty good defense, but their hit points aren't all that much higher than hit points for these other guys. And for some reason, the enemy always likes to gang up on those guys. They were often the guys that would almost, yeah, these guys do it like this, and let's give them that. So that should definitely help. Actually, this is just too good. I want to give that to, yeah, let's take this one here. I want to give that to a wasp. So you guys can heal. There we go. Everybody healed. And yeah, may as well get all the hunters I can get. So here we go. Why doesn't this work? Oh, for some reason I couldn't move these guys. And then let's attack these. I might have to retreat when I attack these guys here, because that's quite a number of guys. So I didn't really have trouble with these guys down here, but they weren't really a pushover either. So let's aggro you, and then let's murder you in front of your friends. There we go. Not a problem. You didn't drop anything. How disappointing. So it's on. If I lose guys now, it's not really all that bad, because I can replace them, and I haven't really leveled up my units, so if I lose them now, I mainly lose food. Oop, now I have leveled them up, and I should actually kill all these guys. Yeah, as I said, these rhinos, everybody always gangs up on the rhinos. Yeah, the same with this guy here. Oh, that's not actually a rhino, so never mind. So, these guys are dead. My units have leveled up. That's how we like it. Here's my ranged units. So, yeah, I might want to establish a second base here even. Because there's a fishing spot here, and there's... Oh wait, where are those turtles? Oh, here they are. Yeah, I might just put another hive here. Anyway, so this guy here ran out of food. So you can harvest these crystals. Are there more crystals somewhere here? Guess not. So here's this plateau. So you're free as well. You can just stay here for now. There's not a whole left. A lot of stuff left here. Didn't I tell you guys to move over here? Where are you? Okay, why? For some reason I can't control these units on occasions. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. So you just move over there, because you need healing badly. And let's get the wasps. Let's get the wasps. Still like the wasps, even though they're still very fragile. I think they're a bit too fragile, but they're also very fast, so they tend to rush into battle first if you don't control them separately. So there's that. So you guys, please heal up. You had to replace... I don't know what's up with this, but okay. I'm clicking, so I'm deselecting these guys, I'm selecting them, and then I'm clicking, and it doesn't work. It should work, and it's annoying, because when I select these guys now, I don't want to be forced to select them separately all the time. What's up with this? I can control everybody else, so it's not the mouse. But yeah, who cares? It seems to be... Did they accidentally select like a building and put it into the group, so now I can't move these guys? Yeah, whatever. So you get up here as well. And where did I? No, those are legionnaires, so should be good here. And here are my wasps. Wasps need all the help they can get, because they're just so damn fragile. Yeah, that's a good item. Stinger, might as well give them a. Yeah, why not? The dive attack isn't overwhelming, to be honest. I mean, the attack is 21, so I might as well lower it a little bit to get this sweet, sweet defense plus 3 bonus, because that's really that good. So, and you get this. Wait, what does this? Oh yeah, it gets my gives the units my health. That's it's nice as well. So let's give you this and this and. Nope, that's a defense penalty. I don't want that. Avatar maybe, if you can actually. This one here, yeah, that I might actually give this one here to the wasp instead. Sounds good to me. So let's heal you guys up now that you have more hit points. Yep, here we go. So time to go after those guys now that my army is complete. The skeleton dudes, they're quite strong. Not gonna lie, and they're ranged. So let's go for those guys first. Yeah, they are draining dealt with my ranged units quite quickly. Even though, I mean, I'm still not really in danger of dying here or anytime soon, but still. So, oh yeah, there was a couple more guys here. And yeah, you guys are harvesting here. I'm not going to build an extra hive there because I'm not desperate for food right now. And yeah, you're still harvesting. And I don't want to waste too many resources because, oh, there's another one here. Oh, and yeah, here we go. So let's just quickly kill you. There we go. And you know what? Where's my queen? There she is. Let's call a worker. There we go. And you open this chest because that's something only workers can do, obviously. And a weapon. What kind of weapon is that? Oh, this one here. Oh, that's actually not that bad. It looks kind of terrible, but it's not actually that bad. And why didn't I equip that? Did I get that from an enemy? Maybe. Okay, so this. So let's separate you guys from everybody else. And let's see. Okay, so now that makes sense. You can actually. Oh, there's another pond here. I mean, it's not the most efficient strategy to harvest here like this, but I may as well do it because at the moment I'm not under pressure, so can probably kill. Can I kill these guys? I'm pretty sure I can kill these guys. Oh, more crystals too. I really have to search this map more thoroughly after I have disposed of all those guys. So I established a little base here. But there are some more mineral veins on this map overlooked first. There's another one here, and there's a third one here. So there are plenty of minerals. And I think these hives here should cover my cost because I don't really use a lot of resources right now, so I can just whenever workers run out of a food on at one food source, I can just move on to the next one. So yeah, here's another one. They all are worth 250 minerals, which is pretty good. And it seems to be the only mineral vein size, to be honest, so there isn't much to choose from. So let's take on these guys here. And you guys, I don't want you at the front lines. Yeah, when you have these warps, you can also distract the enemies for a while. What you can do is you can. Actually, I want you to open this chest. I could just summon another worker because why not? I'm that lazy. So here we go. Nice temple here. And yeah, before I kill all of these guys here, I want to be ready for the Chalatoi. So here we go, you can open this. Let's see what's in here. Whoop. A weapon and clamps. Okay, it's cute. Ooh, glowing clamps. So this one here looks pretty good. Claw off. Veliek the Behemoth. This is the claw of Veliek the Behemoth. It is said the battle lasted for days and thousands fell before the great beast fell. Change the name on head. Pretty good. Also worth 110 DNA, which is quite a bit. But we'll see. Well, that's worth it. Dissolving that. Not right now. Anyway, so you get back here. And I should probably equip that to somebody. For example. I wonder whether ranged units can actually use that. I'll just give it a shot. Because why not? I wonder whether there's probably an upper limit to upgrades, but I wonder how many upgrades you can get. If you can get something like 5 or so, that would be great. But then again, you probably have to farm units forever to get that done. So. Anybody here out of a job? Doesn't look like it, at least not right now. Actually, you are. It's good. So you can kill this guy here. And how's it looking here? It's looking good, it's looking good. You are far from done. It's also good. Yeah, so we can continue like this for a while. The Chalator don't really seem to be building up any armies, so probably good just take my time here. So this game is rather slow paced, but as soon as it becomes fast paced, it becomes ridiculously difficult. Like that one mission where I just got destroyed in no time. Because I didn't build up my army right away. So, here we go. I'm actually going to leave you two alive. And actually you three. I mean, oh, this guy here. That guy is no doubt the boss. So I can probably get away with killing his buddies. And then kill the boss last when I have sufficient resources for my war against Chalatoi. There we go. Gained some more levels, it's nice. These guys are on their way to level 5, which is excellent. Yeah, after a couple of levels it really shows that your units are leveled up. At first not so noticeable, but after a couple of levels you really notice they grind through those other units way, way faster than they did before. So there's another pond here. There's a lot of resources. At first I thought I was kind of resource starved on this map, but I'm not. Quite the contrary. I had way less resources on the previous map. And one of the reasons I had more resources there was because that map had enemy forces that also used resources and used the same as I did. So yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. So, the question is, will these guys attack me straight away when I kill that guy? Probably. So what I could of course split my army. For example, take these guys and take on that guy. That should work. So let's do that. Let's move you guys over here. If that's not the spot where the crossing will appear, then I will be thoroughly disappointed. And you know what? We can actually build... You can actually build an upgrade building. So, worker den. I mean, we don't really need a worker den here, but I may as well just build it here out of convenience. So some guys don't have to move quite as fast. As far. And as fast also. But then again, they shouldn't really move slower just because they have less of a distance to walk now. And this is a video game, so it's not like I can influence that. Because you can't even select these guys. Even though they're so adorable. Also kind of scary if you don't like insects. So, you continue to harvest here. Yeah, all of these are kind of expensive. Yeah, these are really expensive now. Still doing some fishing here. So you guys are in position. So are you, sort of. Yeah, these guys, I think they're enough to take on the boss lord, because the boss lord only has 500 hit points. It's not that much more than a regular one. Still not sure what's up with those one hit point Arlok from the previous mission, but who cares. Anyway, you guys can move in. Yeah, let's just have you guys. Oh, or let's not do it like this. And there we go.
To awaken the old machines. Search the ruins and repair the ancient construct.
Okay, that wasn't quite the cutscene I was expecting, so Let's search for points of interest. So we have whole empty area here. Oh yeah, we have to move over here, obviously. So maybe we don't cross, maybe we do cross over to this area after all, which would be a nice place to build up our base. There's also this important looking podium. Oh, this could actually be another puzzle. That'd be fancy. And here are gates. So yeah. Anyway, you guys, you can go down here and heal up. And then I'm going to send you over to that spot. Maybe they'll even attack me from both sides. That would be a first. Well, not really, but at least they come from completely different sides. So you have harvested all this stuff here, so I may as well send you over. Where do I send you? Yeah, let's actually, there's already a guy there, let's send you over here. So I don't need a worker for that, because if I do, yeah, whatever, let's send these guys over here. So yeah, I might go for the medic next. I still need some more DNA for that, but for now the medic doesn't really seem to be super critical, so I may as well not go for it straight away, but who cares. Anyway, could you guys please, oh yeah, here we go. Oh, so I found that. The question is, it even, oh, there's another one here, so let's get that as well. Okay. Again, this is, again, I can just click on them. I don't have to move units over there. I can just, with my magical mouse cursor, I can just collect those. So that's three. Oh, look at that, the Eiffel Tower. Oh, there's a lot of them here. Oh, I guess that's all five.
We must make the water flow again. Only then can the bridge rise from the depths.
Called it. There's got to be some special water, if it can actually support. Okay, change aqueduct water flow direction, okay. So, oh, it's a puzzle. Well, it's not really a puzzle. This should do it, I guess, at least for this part here. And anything else I can manipulate here? Oh, I can. So here we go. Anything else? Yep. Ooh, this one is slightly more advanced. Actually, I have this. No, I don't, because this one here is higher than the others. So. Anything else? Nope. Ooh.
After thousands of years, the machines speak again.
Sweet. Yeah, there we go.
The temple entrance lies open. Defeat those that stand in our way.
Will do. That's some massive plants there. So it looks like they can't cross here. So let's just send those guys and those guys over there. And you guys can actually, ooh, fish. Yeah, I'm easily distracted. So you guys can actually move over right away and just kill these guys. And are they building a base? So it doesn't look like it. But it doesn't really matter, I guess. So in any case, let's just murder you. Just like I've killed all your friends before. Still not sure how these guys actually look like. Are they supposed to be these bull people, or is it just of war paint or whatever? Yeah, who cares? You get over here. Barely anybody's damaged, so I may as well continue. This is the exact same part we picked up, but except this one here isn't important. How do I even get up? Oh, I guess I can get all the way around here. This looks like an area where I can make camp. There's also even more resources here. Yeah, this map. Yeah, I thought it was a low resource map. It's not. Not at all. So let's see. So you ran out of resources here. So you can fish here. You can... almost 2,000 food or meat or whatever. That's quite a lot. So you guys can move over here. Whoop, what was... oh, that's just a, like, stone column. Let's kill you guys. There we go. And I can barely click on you because your camera angle. Okay, that's... Nope, that doesn't really help. Yeah, whatever. I don't need to do that. So here we go. I like the camera to be aligned like the minimap is aligned. It all makes things so much easier. And that's it's actually quite a number of guys here. So let's just summon another worker. I like that they explicitly exclude these guys from the worker limit. It's very convenient. Let's just build a hive here. So you guys can get over here. So can you guys. Yeah, you're way behind, but then again, who cares? So... Oh, you took... It took you a long time to get down there for some reason. Not sure what was up with that. So you have harvested these minerals, so may as well harvest this guy here. You have done your job here, so you can get... Where can you get to? Just go for this guy here. It's not like it's really important. So you just recollect those minerals. And actually, wait. Oh, that was the wrong guy. Never mind. Yeah, this... Maybe they are going to throw a boss at me. Maybe there's a massive guy going to come out of these gates. But for now, this seems to be a lot easier than many of the previous missions. So... Just quickly kill these guys here. Yeah, the wasps, they are fragile, but they deal damage. It's not even funny. And I didn't kill that guy properly. But now I did. And more lizards. These lizards, they seem to be so weak. Their defense and offense isn't actually too bad, and their hit points are even above average, but they just seem to die so quickly. Bam, dead. And... Bam, dead. So... What? What noises were that? That sounded weird. Never mind, let's heal up. And let's get... Didn't I send... These guys are still collecting this food here. Are these guys? They're a little bit slower than my workers, definitely. So, and these units are still jiggering, that needs to be fixed. But then again, this game is supposed to be upgraded in about 2 weeks, I think 13 days and something. So it has a nice countdown on the start screen, which is something I like. Gives you a good idea about... Oh, are we? Yes, we are. Of course we are. So... Yep. Don't get too eager. There we go. That's why you keep your army together. So, here we go. Can't destroy these, but I can kill this lizard here. Okay, and dead. So... Let's... heal up here. And... So here's another nice bottleneck. I like that. Can just cross here. These are a lot of guys. I definitely have to build a hive here and then just lure them out. Otherwise, this is not going to end well. I mean, my army is strong, but I don't want to lose guys now. Not that they are on their way to level 7. So, that should do it. And I do have a lot of resources. It's not even funny anymore. Oh, now I made all of these guys here angry. That's actually kind of a lot of guys. This here, oh, that's the boss. Oh, and now they're just moving away because I left their aggro range. Let's see whether I can do that again. Hey there, how are you doing? Okay, let's see whether I control these guys here a little bit. So, nope. Hello. Yeah, how about you guys? So, oh no, you guys don't want to fight. Maybe you. Yep. You definitely want to fight. Now you're dead. So your friends and you. And you are actually a lot weaker than I thought you would be. But that's okay. And you too. Now you're all dead. So, ooh. Winter, oh, albino pelt. Thought it was a winter wolf pelt. But anyway, let's summon a worker. I wonder what the range of that is. And let's build a new hive on their corpses. Literally on their corpses. And that's Chief's Hut. Let's see whether we can destroy that from a distance. Looks like we can. That's going to take a while. But then again, it's not like we don't have time. And that was the bulk of the army, because these guys here aren't really doing a whole lot. These guys here kill turtles, which is why they're damaged. Not that that matters, really. At least not to me. You are out of turtle, so you can move all the way over here. So, here we go. You can go over here. I'm really not building base defense. This is one of those missions where I actually have the resources to do so. But there's just no reason to really do it. Because I'm not under enough of a threat to do it. And now I have resources, but in most missions you have so few resources, you can barely build maybe two hives. And possibly barracks and your advanced buildings. And then you're already out of resources. Can you please stop? Thank you. These guys, they really need to learn to stop and fight. Except for these guys, because they're so weak. They're just kneeling over whenever you look at them for more than a second. We had that before, that these guys, they just wouldn't stop. Oh, come on. Just stop and get yourself killed. Thank you. There we go. Oh, a scroll. Let's quickly destroy that building before they start to spam more guys like this. Yeah, that's what I mean. You could just farm these guys. I'm not really sure whether these guys that are... Ooh, 60 DNA, that's a lot. So these guys actually drop items when they're not guys that are placed on the map. Come on. Oh, come on, just die, thank you. I mean, then again, it's actually pretty annoying to fight guys like this, because they're always trying to escape. I actually build a base defense here, just to see how that ends. Build it right here. Nope. You do not attack that. I want that intact for now. Let's just see whether any of these guys drop a scroll. Or not a scroll, but just any item, really. And dead. I mean, it's not like they do that all the time. It's kind of rare in general. Let's kill you. Not sure whether these lizards ever drop anything, really. Oh, and then they drop jewels. That's interesting. So as you can see, I farmed these guys. And now I have 380 DNA. And they seem to drop items that give you DNA, or only DNA, regularly. And they rarely drop weapons and rings and stuff like that. Some of which are really good, so I'm pretty sure if I kill these guys here, then I will get at least one item that gives me 20 DNA or so. So let's just move on. Load that up. And now you are coming after me. You're probably trying to rebuild that, but it's not going to happen. There we go. And let's take on these guys here. Look, there's actually several guys being like overlapped here. Where are we under attack? Oh, can you please? These guys, I really need to stand and fight. Let's kill you, let's kill you, and let's kill you. There we go. I also leveled up my units nicely. Some of them are above level 10 now, which is pretty good. I'm not really sure how many overlapping guys those are, so I'm going to heal up before I get over to those guys. And yeah, then we should be good. But I'm pretty sure there's something's going to happen here, because this doesn't really look like it's going to end here. There's probably some sort of boss. But we'll see. Also built this turret here. Plant turret, because those guys who come out of the barracks, they go straight for my base, and they go only for my base. You really have to go out of your way to stop them and actually have them attack you. And these guys here, oh, it's several guys overlapping. I mean, so the formation was, that's a very interesting formation, which could also explain those guys popping out of nowhere. You need to retreat. Yeah. So you, please die, and you. Yeah, that explains these guys popping out of nowhere. They're just units overlapping. So here we go. That didn't give me any items. How disappointing. Anyway, I'm going to heal up once more before I take on those guys, because if there's a boss, I want to be ready. Let's check my queen. So queen can summon a worker, so that cooldown is gone. That's good. So here we go. Lost only one of these guys here. It's not too bad. And yeah, so let's move over here and kill the last guys. Provide those are actually the last guys. So there's one boss here, and well, not one real boss, one advanced Chalatoi, or whatever you want to call that. So you are out of work here, so you may as well move up all the way up here, because why not? The same goes for you. And I do have a hive here, so it's not too much work. And you... Oh, you're actually dead. Someone killed you. Oh, a dinosaur killed you. What a shame. So, and are you guys still... Nope, you're no longer employed, so you can actually move all the way up here. Not really sure whether we'll ever get there before I finish the mission. Look at these guys, this conga line here. So I love that. So let's actually check out the avatar. Looks like he's on a crutch, like he's using his giant lobster claw as a crutch. 38 attack. I thought the wasps had high attack. That guy is... That's not even funny anymore. I'm using that phrase way too often, especially today. Then again, who cares? So, let's quickly just kill you, and let's kill you. And whoa, leveled up again. These guys pack quite some punch. I think the only time when I had higher level units was in that one mission where you get attacked all the time, immediately. Because there you're basically forced to level up, otherwise you're just going to die. So here we go. Okay. So do I have to like arrange that properly? Let's do it. Question is, if this is actually the right direction? We'll see. That those two align, or do no? This is surprisingly hard to see. Even though eventually I should solve it by pure chance. So here we go. Looks like some really, really ugly lion. So do I have to put units on here? Like a wasp and a worker or something? And this... No, that's not quite aligned correctly. This seems to fit. Oh, it's the central... Yeah, the central part... That definitely fits here. These fins here are correct, and no, these ones here, these ones don't look quite right, so maybe that wasn't it. This one here, yeah that looks good. Oh yeah, it is.
Who dares awaken Arcanoth?
Yeah, called it.
Who defies the will of my maker?
Ooh, that guy is, he's angry. He's like that angry neighbor that tells you to get off his lawn. Whoa, you're tall, you have 10,000 hit points. That's quite a lot. You know what, how far away can you, oh yeah, you do have to walk a little bit. Yeah, I can't even bother to just get a worker over here. I'm just that lazy. So let's build a hive here as usual. It's not like we lack the resources. So let's build a hive right here. So, in this puzzle, it's almost not really a puzzle, because eventually you just solve it by chance. But that was surprisingly difficult to see. It looks like a mix between lobster, sea spider, / real spider, and lion. It's terrifying. So, but I should be able to pull this off. Still haven't got the medics, but Hmm. I could dissolve like a minor mana artifact. What did I just do? Oh, I just unequipped that, so. Let's dissolve and let's get the medic, so I have the medic right from the start in the next mission, provided there's little time to, or little resource to actually get the medic. So yeah, let's do that. Yeah. Let's get yet another barracks here, so I don't have to walk my medics all the way over here, because I'm just that lazy. And then we should be good. So I did build, well, I didn't build the medic, I got the medic upgrade. And apparently you can also get a regeneration ability for that, which is probably because the medic might not be able to heal itself. That's a common thing in video games. But I can't build it because actually I've hit the hard unit limit. Not only the soft ones for units, but the hard ones. So maybe next time. But if I do build it next time, I might, let's say, not build one of the rhinos. And instead build a medic, just to see what the medic is like. So, oh yeah, there you go. So you are, whoa, you're also fast, considering. Whoa, it's one of those. One of those abilities. So, are we in the regenerating? Yeah, we are. This area here, so, and this guy. Yeah, good thing we're regenerating, otherwise it would be different story, so let's just try to get out of the way here. Ooh, he's got special skills, and now he's frozen for some reason. No, he's not, but he just paused there for a moment. And yeah, I totally got this guy. Not even going to lose a single unit here. Yep, this guy is complete toast, I hope. Yeah. Even with these rocks here, he's actually pretty strong, but since I'm regenerating all the time, it's not that much of a problem. Yeah, hive cheese is really what I recommend here. Can I get his massive sword? That would be awesome.
First of the Chalatoi lies dead on your feet. Way to the temple is open. Claim your destiny.
Yep, we will claim our destiny, but we're going to do that next time. So thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time in the final mission. Take care and goodbye.